Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to a video about Monica by the Mucho Sexy Tricycle Team. Yummy. It was their mistake to neglect me from previous coverage of Doki Doki Literature Club, and they're bad at following trends and want to milk the
dead meme
that is me still by their own free will.
Dead meme.
They have made this video about me, just Monica.
Dead?
It is insulting to my intellect, but the intention is pure. Power to the proletariat.
Power to the proletariat.
What? How did I get into this video? Oh, Monica. Hi. I guess you're here because we kind of left you out of our last DDLC video, didn't we? Well, what's that? Well, when you put it that way, I guess I pretty much have to make a video for just you, don't I? And she deserves it. We analyzed every other character, talked about their lives and mental issues, but we left out Monica. And for good reason. She doesn't quite fit in with the other characters. Turns out, when your mental issue is being a sentient program within a game, that doesn't quite meld well into the same video with depression, abuse, and self-harm. You can't go to a therapist to fix robotic sentience, you know? But perhaps you haven't thought about what that sentience actually means for Monica, and how it explains the deranged cutie we know and love. And fear. You may think you understand Monica, but in reality, there's a much deeper story that we have yet to uncover. A truth about her that hits closer to home than you may realize. So join me on a tale of sorrow and madness, through an adventure to understand Monica, and possibly so much more. Today, we venture into a story lost in time, one that, just like Monica, we accidentally neglected until the very end. This is Monica, just Monica, the story you never knew. Oh, Monica, thou art a crazy biatch. But why? What made you go so insane that you literally destroyed the entire world, all your friends, and our poetry club just to get into my pants? And while I am flattered by your advances, I'm a bit confused. Being sentient doesn't create insanity. Or, you know, maybe it does. Our world is pretty insane these days. But my point is that the majority of us know who we are and what we are. And yet, we don't go around killing our friends and world just so we can blow that one guy we like in a house floating in virtual nothingness. So what makes Monica different? What gives her that little bump to the wrong side of the crazy hot scale? To answer that, we must go back over what really happened to Monica and how she went from Katy Perry style hot cool girl at school to a Katy Perry style flaming cold psychopath. With that sweet 2008 song lyric reference out of the way, let's go back to the beginning of the game. We meet Monica after Sayori guilt trips our butt to the poetry club. You can already tell at this point she's totally digging us, and who can blame her? But to be fair, all these girls are madly in love with us from the start. Such is the way of the virtual waifu.
Oh, Grant, you're so sexy and hot. I'd kill a bitch if they tried to take you from me.
At first, Monica just seems like a nice tutorial or helper character. She gives you tips, including things that can relate to the game itself, which breaks the fourth wall. But as the days go on, it gets more and more obvious she's not super happy with all the female attention we're getting from our classmates. While her initial objections are subtle, after poop hits the blade machine, Monica gets more and more aggressive in assuring that we spend time with her, and not the other girls. She wants not only to be the center of attention, but the only thing we can give attention to. Monica desires our love so much that she ends up forcing us to choose spending time with her no matter how hard we want to bang Yuri. And after everyone else essentially kills themselves in front of us, Monica takes complete control of the game until we delete her. And sure, we've all had that high school relationship where your girlfriend tries to take over your life and make you a slave, right? No, we don't live in an anime. Unfortunately. When you think about it, that's one hell of a psychological jump for her to make. So the next logical conclusion is that she's insane, right? Monica's inability to be with us, plus waifu, drove her to a breaking point wherein she pushed Sayori's depression to the point of suicide by neck ouch, increased Yuri's self-harm to the point of suicide by stabbies, and essentially just virtually broke Natsuki while she was at it. That's the story we saw, and we all thought, oh dang, she's crazy! But that's not what really happened. that's only the side we saw. We didn't get to witness the deterioration of Monica from her angle. And that lack of viewpoint leaves us neglecting a vital piece of information. After we delete Monica, Sayori becomes sentient and goes insane, attempting to take us completely for herself. She almost immediately falls right into the role Monica was playing. This isn't an isolated incident. It isn't just Monica, despite what Monica tells us over and over. It's not Monica's character that replicated this insanity. It was able to be replicated in Sayori just by transferring the sentience and understanding of the situation to her. This means this sentience, the understanding of the game and a purpose inside it, is what creates the insanity in Monica. Monica as a person and a character is completely fine. There's nothing inherently about her or different when you remove that sentience. Instead of thinking Monica is insane, we need to dig into that sentience and what makes it different from our own ability to know who we are, what we are, and why we are here. The problem with Monica, or more specifically, Monica's sentient nature, is that her understanding of her world was different than how we comprehend our own. Her knowledge of her life, of others, of the world she lived in, was complete. She knew everything. She understood everything. She knew her exact purpose within the game, as well as everyone else's. She knew she was just a character within a simulation. Monica understood it all. And that knowledge, is the true culprit to Monica's character. If in the blink of an eye, you knew your entire life, how it would end, what you would and wouldn't get out of it, how long you would live, whether you'd find love, get the job you want, have children, keep the friends you have, be happy, be sad, be heartbroken, and never find the love of your life, it would drive you mad. It's the ultimate hypocrisy of being human. We are constantly learning, striving to know more than we do, attempting to understand everything around us. It's a natural state of humanity. We live to learn, to understand more, and better comprehend and where we are on this planet, and what our purpose is in life. Why do you think religion has had such a hold on our global society for so long? It gave answers to those profound questions we as a society were searching for without ever actually explaining the ins and outs of reality to us. This is simultaneously humanity's greatest strength, and as we see in Monica, our greatest weakness. It gives us the drive to move forward, to push for something better, to have goals and make steps towards achieving them. It gives us hope. Not knowing what is going to happen tomorrow is the underlying reason we get out of bed in the morning. Each day holds new opportunity to learn, to understand more, to find what we want and continue our journey through life. We want to be the best, most knowledgeable, and most capable we can be. And yet, when you take that idea to the extreme, it's what drove Monica mad, and then Sayori. We as humans want to know everything, but we can't. It's literally impossible for us to know everything, to know how our lives will end up, to know our future. And that lack of knowledge makes each day unique. Even right now, as I'm writing this video, I don't know what the next sentence is going to be, and that lack of knowledge keeps me writing. Because if I knew, why would I keep going? I already know how it ends. Monica's life is like a video that's already been made, that she's watched a million times. She knows exactly how it's going to be each and every day. Monica, unlike us, knows exactly what will happen. She knows she won't find love. She knows she's just a game, a character within a simulation. And it's that understanding and self-awareness of not just living within a game, but of everything, that is what drove her to a breaking point. But think about it, would it actually be any different outside of a game? If you knew your entire life, front to back, if every day you knew exactly how it was going to play out, how would you still live? There would be no reason to do anything. There would be no spark left. And that's the true hypocrisy of sentience. Knowing who you are, what you are, why you are here. Those are all vital to us as humans. You constantly hear people talk about finding their purpose in life, finding their path, understanding who they are. Those ideas, the feeling of being on the right road, gives us drive to move forward. If we don't have those things, it can lead to feelings of being lost, alone, and depressed. We can't have no purpose, but we can't know our entire purpose either. Each side is like the edge of a knife. Tipping too far to either side can make us fall into madness and depression. As humans within our world, we can never know too much. It just isn't possible. So when we have issues with purpose, it's because we feel like we have none. Monica's issue is the exact opposite, but leads to the same thoughts. Knowing everything is essentially the same as knowing nothing in terms of purpose. If you know your entire purpose and the entire purpose of the world you live in, there's no reason to live it. The process of living and discovering is the journey to understand why we are here. Monica went insane because she knew exactly why she was there to a T, and her solution was to destroy her original purpose and create a new one. And I can't blame her. Had I been in the same place and known exactly what my life was going to be from this point on, I also would attempt to change it. Because knowing everything leads to nowhere. It's the journey of finding new things and understandings that creates an interesting and livable life. Isn't that why you're here, watching this video? It was something you didn't know, so you clicked on it because you wanted to. If you already knew every word of this video, why would you ever click it? That's the true reasoning behind Monica and her life, an idea that is so much closer to our minds than we ever could have realized. That's the story of what it means to know everything. The story of a sad girl who knew it all and fought against her own manifested destiny for sanity's sake. That's the story of Monica. The story you never knew. There you are, Monica, a video all your own. I know you really did go a bit crazy there, but at least we can relate to you in a way. Also, if you aren't Monica and you like our philosophical stuff, you should check out our Twitch streams on twitch.tv/treesicle. Every weekday at 3 p.m. Pacific time, where we have some pretty deep conversations with the chat on various issues and topics. Usually, we start the games and philosophical BS at 3 p.m. Of course, we also sometimes have meme battles. It's a toss-up!
Oh, you sound like the fish from SpongeBob.
But either way, come hang out, say hi, join the amazing chat fam, and find out even more about what we do and how we do it. I'm Grant. That's all for me today. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!